Can anyone hear this? My name is Edward Borman, and I'm trapped on top of the city building. I'm alone. Can anyone hear me? Did anyone hear me? I need help. Because I don't know what you are.
Yet you were afraid before you stepped through the door. And though you have heard others speak of me, still, you fear me.
Who are you?
I am the herald of the great worlds, captain of the ocean of storms, and commander of the League. I am Dr. Tomorrow.
You've taken Jack.
I know. And if not for the mistake of overlooking you, we would have no reason for hope. Tonight we have learned that the chief designer has come upon the ability to travel worlds and the means by which he has chosen to use it. And though you owe me no allegiance, I must ask you to bend every effort in freeing Jack to destroy the gravity engine.
Me? Can't you do something? Send someone else?
This task cannot be shifted to another.
But I am alone. I need help.
There is none.
And if I'm killed?
The moon will fall.
What's the sense of letting something like this depend on me? I'm nothing.
Great things have been asked of you every day, whether you recognize them or not.
I'm sorry. I can't. I just can't. It's impossible.
Impossible? The men of Earth had done the impossible. In the long life of this galaxy, until this very night, no race has ever escaped a planet's gravity to set foot on another world, save for one.
We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard. For the eyes of the world now look into space, to the moon, and to the planets beyond.
Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11. Tower clear.
on this new theme. Because there is new knowledge to be gained and new rights to be won. And they must be won and used for the progress of all people.
Houston, you are go for data.
For the first time, mankind did escape the timeless grip of Earth and came under the stewardship of another celestial body.
I'm going to step off the land now. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
I was witness to the greatest and most dangerous adventure on which man had ever embarked. The impossible. It is because of their ingenuity, their immeasurable capacity for bravery, that I have chosen the men of Earth to serve in my league as the men of tomorrow. Ambassadors to the new worlds and custodians of this great and dangerous new instrument of travel which they have introduced to the greater galaxy. You share these same abilities. And though you search every crack to escape, now that you see the